responsible for locomotion. So, then we'll study about cockroach or Periplaneta americana. This is the biological or scientific name of cockroach. You all are familiar with the cockroach. These are inside in your bed, in your bedroom. These are inside in your chair, in your bedroom, in all your household wares. So, cockroach. See, this is a picture of cockroach. Cockroach, the body of cockroach is divisible into three parts. Head, thorax region, and abdomen. So, the head of cockroach is hypoganthus, or you can say in other words, facing downwards. And it is form of six segment. Or you can say it is form of the fusion of six segment. Head is triangular pear shaped in outline. And anteriorly, mouth parts attached to the head capsule or to the head. These are the mouth parts attached to the head. These mouth parts help in chewing, cutting and swallowing the food. This is labrum. It is a movable, broad, oblong, bilobed, chitinous flap which hangs from head region and functions as upper lip. This is mandible. This is grinding region and incising region. They are two triangular, toothed, strong, chitinous structure. These are two in pair, mandible, which can, they all work against each other, causing cutting and crushing of food. These are the pair of maxilla teeth. The first pair of maxilla, they lie on the sides. Each first maxilla has a bristly and clawed lacinia for holding food and fine jointed bristly maxillary pulp for cleaning antenna and legs. Second pair of maxilla, they form the lower lip. The same contain glossy, paraglossy and 2-3 jointed sensory labial pulps. So, second pair of maxilla help in pushing the food inwards and preventing its escape during crushing. This is hypopharynx, or it is also called lingua. It is a median flexible lobe that lies in preoral cavity surrounded by mouth parts. It possesses sensory receptors and opening of common salivary duct, and labrum from the lower lip. So, these are the mouth parts of cockroach present in the head region of the cockroach. So, these are the mouth parts of cockroach present in the head region. Now, thorax of cockroach. Thorax is the middle part of the body, which is divisible into three segments. And these three segments are prothorax, mesothorax, and metathorax. Each segment of both thorax and abdomen is covered by four chitinous plates or sclerites. Each segment of thorax are covered by four chitinous plates. We will study about these plates later. So, thorax consists of three parts: prothorax, mesothorax, and metathorax. Thorax is actually a locomotor center of the body. It possesses three pairs of legs. You can see here the three pairs of legs and two pairs of wings. Wings are of two types, forewing and hind wings. Forewings are mesothoracic in origin, dark, leathery and opaque structures which do not take part in flight but instead cover the flight wings during rest. They are also called wing covers, elytra or tegmina. But hind wings are metathoracic. Hind wings are metathoracic in origin, broad, transparent, thin and membranous, which are kept folded when not in use. Both the type of wings possess hollow wings. So, this is all about the thoracic part of cockroach. Now, saline features of cockroach. Cockroaches are world wild and found in the places which are dark, warm, damp and where plenty of organic debris is found. You can see them in sewage pipes, kitchens, bakeries, restaurants, grocery shops, warehouses, railway compartments, etc. They are nocturnal and omnivorous. Nocturnal means the animals are more active at night. And omnivorous, they eat both plants and animals. There are three main species of cockroaches found in India. And these are periplaneta americana, blatta orientalis, and third one is blatta germanica. Now, external features of cockroach. You can see here, body is narrow, elongated, bilaterally symmetrical. It means when we will cut the body from the axis, the one part is a mirror image of another part. The body is flattened and measuring about approximately 3 to 4 cm in length and 1 to 2 cm in breadth. And you all know the color is reddish brown with a pale yellow area around the edge of the pronotum. These are wings, antenna, eyes. Now, exoskeleton of cockroach. The entire body of the cockroach is covered with a thick, hard chitinous cuticle which is secreted by epidermis. So, body is covered on outside by a hard chitinous exoskeleton formed of a number of plates called sclerites. You can see here the picture of cockroach. This is cuticle which is secreted by epidermis and these are sclerites. Every segment of cockroach is formed of sclerites. Now, you can see here the four chitinous plates or sclerite. This is the dorsal portion, this is ventral portion and this is abdomen portion, because each segment of thorax and abdomen is covered by four chitinous plates or sclerite. Dorsal sclerites are called tergum or tergite. These are lateral sclerites and we call it pleura or pleurites. Now, ventral sclerites called sternum or sternite, and they are also two lateral pleura. So, the tergum of prothorax is the largest. These are the four plates of chitinous sclerites, 7, 8, 9, 10. These are the dorsal portion. These are the four plates of ventral sclerites, 8, 6, 7, 6, 7, 8. And ninth is covered with other segment. So, these are the four chitinous plates or sclerite of abdomen side, which we call tergum and sternum. And sclerites of each segment are joined together by articular or arthroidal membranes. This articular membrane is flexible. Hair-like appendages called ceta are also present in the cuticle. And they are secreted by trichogen cells of hypodermis. They help in the movement. Now, segmentation. As we all know that the body of cockroach is segmented. Why an animal needs segmentation? Because through division into segments, animal bodies can reach higher degrees of complexity and functionality during development and evolution. In embryo, 20 segments are present, in which 6 in head, 3 in thorax and 11 in abdomen. But in adult, 14 segments are present. In adult, 1 in head, 3 in thorax and 10 in abdomen. Because due to incomplete infusion, some segments during development, the number of distinct segments are reduced. All the segments of head are fused and form head capsule. So, the exoskeleton of head or head capsule is formed by the fusion of 6 segments of head. Thorax consists 3 segments and these are prothorax, mesothorax and metathorax. And only 10 segments are retained in the abdomen of the adult, out of which only the first 7 are distinct in females and first 9 in males. The remain will hinder behind abdominal sac. So, when we will remove the wings, 3 regions are clearly visible in the cockroach and these are head, thorax and abdomen. A small, soft and mobile neck is also present between the head and thorax. It is covered over by 2 dorsal and 2 ventral sclerites, or we can also say them cervical sclerites. It is covered over by 2 dorsal and 2 ventral sclerites and we can also say them cervical sclerites. Now, head. Head of cockroach is triangular, pear-shaped in outline. It is hypoganthus, that is bent downwardly. Head bears a pair of compound eyes, simple eyes, a pair of antenna and mouth parts. And the two compound eyes are broad, kidney-shaped, sessile, black and dorsolateral, one on each side. Actually, cuticle is invaginated in head and thorax region to form endoskeletal elements, or we can also say them tentorium. And they function as sites for the attachment of muscles. So the endoskeleton of head is called tentorium. And all the sclerates of head are fused, forming a strong head capsule, which are formed by the fusion of six segments. You can see here the picture of head. These are two epicranial plates, a triangular frons, a rectangular slipeus, a movable labrum, or you can say it upper lip, two lateral cheek sclerites or zina. You can see here, head bears a pair of compound eyes, antenna and mouth parts. You can see here, antenna occur in front of compound eyes. They are long sensitive threads. Each antenna develops from a depression called antennal socket. These are antennal socket. Antenna bear a number of sensory bristles, hairs and pegs. Antenna can move in all direction. This is ocellar spot or fenestra. These are simple eyes that occur near antennal sockets. They are lighter areas which are sensitive to light intensity. Pair of whitish spot present. They lie at the base of the antenna. And they are called fenestra. So, this is all about the head of cockroach. This is the dorsal view. You can see here, these representing simple eyes. Now, thorax region of cockroach. It is the middle part of the body, which is divisible into three parts. And these are prothorax, mesothorax and thorax. The three thoracic segments are covered by relatively thicker and large tergites called nota. Tergites are chitinous plates, and each mesonotum and metanotum bears a pair of wings. You can see here the division of thorax region. Actually, thorax is the locomotor center of the body. It possesses three pairs of legs, 1, 2, 3, and two pairs of wings. Two pairs of wings are, these are fore wings and these are hind wings. Fore wings are mesothoracic in origin, dark, leathery and opaque structures which do not take part in flight but instead cover the flight wings during rest. They are also called wing covers, elytra or tegmina. Hind wings or fly wings are, these are hind wings or fly wings are the thoracic in origin, broad, transparent, thin and membranous, which are kept folded when not in use. Both the type of wings possess hollow wings. So you can see here the thorax region, this is prothorax, this is mesothorax and this is metathorax. This is notum of prothorax or plates of cuticle. This is notum of mesothorax and this is notum of metathorax. Now, abdomen of cockroach. As we all know, it is the largest and broadest part behind the thorax. It is divisible into 10 segments. And each segment has 4 sclerites. And these are a dorsal tergum, a ventral sternum, and 2 lateral pleura. Sternum is absent in 10 segments. In male, all the 9 sterna are visible. In female, only 7 sterna are visible, since the 7th sternum is produced backwardly to form board-shaped floor of utricle chamber. You can see in the picture, in female, 7th sterna is larger and board-shaped. And together with indistinct 8th and 9th sternite, forms a chamber called gynoecium. Posterior part of this chamber is called utical chamber or brood pouch. 8th and 9th sterna produce respectively anterior wall and roof of the utical chamber. In male cockroach, 7th tergum covers the 8th tergum, while in female cockroach, 7th tergum covers both the 8th and 9th terga. Female genital pore opens through 8th sternum into utical chamber, while male genital aperture lies below the anus in between 10th tergum and 9th sternum. In males, 9th sternite bears a pair of spine-like anal styles. They are unjointed filaments and called anal style. And anal occurs on the undersurface of the 10th tergum. Both the genital apertures of male and female are surrounded by a chitinous outgrowth called gynapophysis or external genitalia. And at several places, certain processes of exoskeleton extend into the body and form endoskeleton elements which provide attachment to muscles and called apodeme. You can see here the anal styles, the 10th tergum of male, this is the utical chamber of female. Moreover, in both the sexes, 10th segment possesses 215 jointed filamentous structure, and these are called anal cerci. They help in the process of hearing. This is the hind part of abdomen. And gynapophysis help in copulation. Now, appendages. What are appendages? Appendages are a part or organ that is joined to the axis or trunk of a body. So, first of all, cephalic appendages. What is the meaning of cephalic? Cephalic means appendages of head. So, the four pair of head appendages include antenna, mandibles, first maxilla and second maxilla. First of all, antenna. The anteriormost head appendages are the two antenna. They are sensitive threads. These arise from a socket ventral to the compound eyes. The first article of the antenna is the scape and the second is the pedicel. From the pedicel arises a long whip-like sensory flagellum. Now, the mouthparts. In mouthparts, here comes labrum, mandibles, hypopharynx, maxilla, these all. As we have already discussed about this, so I am explaining here, it is in brief. Labrum, it is a movable, broad, oblong, bilobed chitinous flap which hangs from sclypeus and functions as upper lip. Second one is mandibles. They are two triangular, toothed, strong chitinous structures which can work against each other, causing cutting and crushing of food. Third one is first maxilla. They lie on the sides. Each first maxilla has a bristly and clawed lacinia for holding food and fine jointed bristly maxillary pulp for cleaning antenna and legs. Second pair of maxilla form the lower lip and hypopharynx. It is a median flexible lobe that lies in preoral cavity surrounded by mouthparts. It possesses sensory receptors and opening of common salivary duct. Now, abdominal appendages. There is no locomotory appendages in abdominal part. And there are certain small structures associated with gonopore which are different in male and female cockroaches. In both the sexes, 10th segment possesses 215 jointed filamentous structure called anal cerci. They are connected with hearing. Male cockroach possesses two small unjointed filaments on either side of 9th sternum and these are called anal styles. They help in copulation. Now, thoracic appendages. In thoracic appendages, here comes pair of walking legs. This is a structure of a walking leg. It has a 5 parts. First one is a broad, strong proximal coxa. Coxa attaches the leg to the thorax. Second one is trochanter. Trochanter acts like a knee and lets the cockroach bend its leg. Third one is femur and tibia. Femur and tibia resembles thigh and shin bones. Now, the fourth one is the segmented tarsus. This acts like an ankle and foot. The hook-like tarsus also helps cockroaches climb walls and walk upside down on ceilings. Tarsus is divided into 5 tarsomeres, or you can say it also podomeres. The last tarsomere is called paratarsus, forming the claws and bearing an adhesive aerolium or pulvillus. Similar but smaller adhesive pads called plantula are located at each joint of tarsus. So, this is the structure of walking leg present in thorax region. Now, eyes of cockroach. Cockroach has two types of photoreceptors. These are simple eyes and compound eyes. Simple eyes or ocelli, they are two white patches which occur on upper inner margin of antennal sockets. And simple eyes are sensitive to light intensity and regulate insect activity. Another one is compound eyes. Compound eyes are pair of large kidney shaped structures present dorsoventrally over the head. And each compound eye is formed of number of ommatidia, that is approximately 2000 transparent hexagonal facets or ommatidia present in a compound eye. Each ommatidium has a transparent biconvex cuticle or cornea or corneal lens. Corneal lens are secreted by corneogen cells. And below the corneogen cell, there is a cone surrounded by 4 cone cells called vitrella. Vitrella secrete the crystalline cone, and all this forms focusing region. Rhabdom is also present below the cone. And what is rhabdom? Rhabdom is a spindle shaped 8 unit having visual pigment retinin and surrounded by 8 elongated cells called retinula. So, how the image formed? A nerve fiber picks up the information from the ommatidium for relaying to brain. An ommatidium is separated from adjacent ommatidia by pigmented cells so as to prevent mixing of light rays and images. Then each ommatidium forms an image of a part of object. The full image of the object consists of several small bits of image. Such an image is called mosaic image. It is helpful in locating movement of the object even from a distance, though cockroach is short-sighted. This is a picture of compound eye. You can see here the cornea in which ommatidium are present or 2000 lens are present. This is iris, this is lens, optic nerve, retina, vitreous humor and retinal blood vessels. Now, reproductive system of cockroach. First of all, we'll take male reproductive system. So, cockroaches are dioecious. Or sexes are separate with very clear sexual dimorphism. You can clearly differentiate between male and female cockroaches. Male reproductive system consists of testes, vasa deferentia, mushroom gland, ejaculatory duct, male gonadophyses. So, first of all, mushroom gland, or you can also say it utricular gland. It is a large compound gland formed of long tubules or utriculi majors that helps in the formation of inner layer of spermatophore, and small tubules or utriculi brevivores for nourishing sperms, and small bulb-like seminal vesicle for storing sperms. And all sperms of seminal vesicle are glued together into a large bundle called spermatophore. This is the picture of male reproductive organ. Spermatophore has 3 inner layer secreted by utriculi, as I have already told you, utriculi majors, middle by ejaculatory duct, and outer layer by conglobate gland. Male reproductive system also consists of male gonadophyses. They are 3 chitinous plates called phallomeres. Phallomeres are situated around the male genital pore. These are left phallomere, right phallomere, and ventral phallomere. You can see here the reproductive system of cockroach. These are the lobules of testes, utriculi gland or mushroom gland, vasa deferentia. Actually, each testis leads into a vasa deferentia. Seminal vesicles stores sperms, ejaculatory duct, Ejaculatory duct is a muscular tube which opens at the male genital pore or ninth sternum, anal sulcus, anal style, and this is male gonopore, and these are gynapophyses. So this is all about the reproductive system of male cockroach. Now students, reproductive system of female cockroach. Female reproductive system consists of ovaries, oviduct, vagina, genital chamber, spermatheca, collateral glands, and female gynapophyses. Ovaries of cockroach are located in 4 to 6 abdominal segments, and each ovary consists of 8 ovarioles. Ovaries of cockroach are located in the 2nd to 6th abdominal segments, and each ovary consists of 8 ovarioles. Two short paired oviducts help in carrying ova from ovaries, and two oviducts from each side open into a common oviduct which open into genital chamber. A pair of collateral glands also open in genital chamber. Actually, collateral glands are highly branched tubular glands. The left is larger, both open into genital pouch. It produces scleroprotein for utica. This is the structure of female reproductive organs. Genital pouch, or you can also say it brood pouch or genitrium, is formed by boat shaped seventh sternum. It has openings of collateral glands, spermatheca, and gonopore. Female gonopophyses are also occur. There are 6 criteria structures which form ovipositor or egg-laying apparatus. And utica or genital pouch of cockroach contains 16 fertilized eggs. It is formed of protein secreted by collateral gland. Copulation in cockroach occurs between March to September. Copulation occurs at night. The sperms are transferred to spermatheca of female. 16 eggs are laid in 2 rows in the brood pouch. Sperms are shed over them. Fertilization occurs in brood pouch, and the fertilized eggs are enclosed in purse-shaped utica. Soon, nymphs emerge out of utica. They are like the parent, except that they are small and wingless. After gradual metamorphosis, each gives rise to an adult cockroach. So this is all about the reproductive system of cockroach. And metamorphosis is regulated by 2 hormones. Ecdysone, secreted by pituitary glands, and juvenile hormone, secreted by corpora ileta. Next is circulatory system in cockroaches. In cockroach, blood vascular system is of open type. That means blood remains in direct contact with body tissues instead of flowing inside blood vessels. It flows inside the body cavity called hemocele, and blood is called hemolymph. First of all, hemocele. Body cavity is called hemocele. It is filled with hemolymph, and it is divisible into 3 chambers or sinuses by means of 2 perforated diaphragms, dorsal and ventral. The 3 chambers are dorsal pericardial sinuses, that encloses heart, largest median perivisceral sinuses, that encloses various viscera, and ventral perineural sinus, that encloses nerve cord. Dorsal diaphragm is attached to terga in various segments of the body by means of 12 pairs of conical alary muscles. Alary muscles alternately contract and relax, making the dorsal diaphragm straight and arched. This brings about flow of hemolymph. Blood of cockroach also possesses blood-filled spaces in the head region. They are called head sinuses. Second part is heart. Some workers called it also cardiac complex, but some call heart. Heart is a straight, elongated, tubular, and 13 chambered. These are contractile chamber, and in which in 13 chambers, 3 are thoracic and 10 are abdominal chambers. Each cardiac chamber or heart chamber has 2 lateral incurrent pores called ostia. It opens into next anterior chamber by a ventricular valve which allows flow of blood only in forward direction. Now, third one is blood or hemolymph. Blood of cockroach is colorless. It has a colorless plasma and two types of colorless corpuscles or hemocytes. These are plasmocytes and coagulocytes. Plasma does not contain any respiratory pigment. It possesses non-reducing disaccharide trihalose. This is the characteristic of insects, some algae and mushrooms. It also possesses urates, phosphates and number of other dissolved substances for transport inside the body. Now, circulation of blood. Contraction and relaxation of alveolar muscles straighten and arch the dorsal diaphragm. So overall, alveolar muscles are responsible for blood circulation. And heart contracts at the rate of 50 times per minute. Straightening causes the flow of blood from lower sinuses into pericardial sinuses. And arcing causes the flow of blood into cardiac chambers through ostia. Cardiac chambers also contract one after the other. This pushes the blood into lateral or exscurrent arteries and the anterior aorta. Aorta pushes the blood into head sinuses. From head sinuses and lateral arteries, the blood passes into peripheral and perineural sinuses. This is all about circulation of blood. And blood circulation is completed within 6 minutes, or you can say within 5 to 6 minutes. Next is digestive system of cockroach. It consists of alimentary canal, digestive glands and associated organs that take part in ingestion and digestion of food. Alimentary canal of cockroach is about 6 to 7 cm in length of variable diameter and it is differentiated into three regions, foregut, midgut and hindgut. Foregut, also called stomatium, is the anterior part of alimentary canal, which is lined internally by cuticle for protecting itself from roughness of food particles. It opens into the preoral cavity over the hypopharynx by means of a slit like mouth. Preoral cavity is a space in front of mouth which is bounded by labrum, labium, mandibles and maxilla. Hypopharynx has an opening of common salivary duct. Food is located by antenna, picked up by forelegs and taken into preoral cavity. Here it is mixed with saliva, crushed by mandibles and pushed into foregut through mouth. From mouth, food passes into pharynx. Both mouth and pharynx contain taste sensilla. From pharynx, food enters into esophagus. Esophagus passes into crop. Crop is a large pear-shaped sac that stores food. The posterior 1/3 of the crop has digestive and churning function. Digestive enzymes come from midgut. When empty, crop develops internal folds, gizzard or proventriculus is the last part of foregut. It is conical and muscular. Internally, gizzard has 6 large chitinous teeth in the anterior part for crushing food, 6 thin plates, 6 pads with bristles, studded cushions and fine bristles in the grooves of gizzard. They help in straining of food. Posterior end of gizzard projects into midgut in the form of a narrow tube called stomatal valve. It prevents regurgitation of food. Now, midgut or mesenteron, it is thin walled coiled tube of uniform diameter which has glandular epithelium of endodermal origin. Glandular cells secrete digestive enzymes, and digestive enzymes are also secreted by lining layers of 7 to 8 finger-like blind tubular hepatic cecia, which open into anterior part of midgut. Midgut is not only the seat of digestion, but also absorption of digested food. If the food is rough, it is covered by a thin semi-permeable peritrophic membrane. So, posterior end of midgut possesses a sphincter. Next come hindgut. Hindgut is cuticle lined posterior part of alimentary canal. It has three parts, ileum, colon and rectum. You can see here the picture of alimentary canal of cockroach. This is foregut, midgut, hindgut, this is rectum, this is anus, this is colon, this is Malpighian tubes, gastric cecia and salivary glands. Hindgut comprises ileum, colon and rectum. Ileum is short and narrow, having internal spines at its junction with midgut. It bears a ring of up to 150 yellow thread-like blind excretory malpighian tubules, which pour their product into ileum. Colon is wider and coiled. It stores the undigested food. And rectum is the short, wide, last part of hindgut, which has six longitudinal folds or rectal papilla, having glands probably for absorption of water and mineral salts. The solidified fecal matter is passed out from rectum to the outside through anus that occurs below the 10th sternum. Cockroach is omnivorous, that is, feeding on all types of organic foods like vegetables, meat, fruit, bread, paper, leather, etc. It prefers sugary and starchy foods. Under overcrowded conditions, cockroach can resort to cannibalism, that is, eating one's own kin. Two salivary glands, one on each side of crop, are present. Each salivary gland has two glandular portions and a bladder-like receptacle or reservoir. The secretion of saliva is stored in the reservoir. Saliva contains amylolytic enzymes like amylase, invertase, maltase, lactase, zymase, etc. So most of the nutrients of food are digested in the crop, and absorption takes place in mesenteron. Next is excretory system of cockroach. Cockroach is ureocotylic animal. It means it excretes uric acid as a main nitrogenous waste product. And excretory organs of cockroach consist of malpighian tubules, fat body cells, nephrocytes, uricose glands, and cuticle. So, first of all, we will take malpighian tubules. These are about 150 yellow unbranched blind fine tubules, which open into the alimentary canal at the junction of midgut and hindgut. The tubules float freely in hemolymph. They also exhibit slow peristaltic movements. In the distal part of the malpighian tubules have absorptive cells with brush border. They extract soluble urates from hemolymph. Inside the tubules, urates are changed into insoluble uric acid, and the uric acid is pushed into alimentary canal for elimination along with fecus. Next one is fat body cells. Fat body of the animal contains some special cells called urate cells. The cells extract urates from hemolymph and store it as insoluble uric acid. It is an example of storage excretion. Third one is nephrocyte. They are binucleate cells which occur in the pericardial sinus along the sides of heart. Nephrocytes perform storage excretion. Next one is uricose glands. In the mushroom gland of the male cockroach are present long peripheral blind tubules which can store uric acid and pass out the same over the spermatophore at the time of copulation. Last one is cuticle. Nitrogenous waste materials are deposited in the cuticle. They remain there till the shedding of cuticle at the time of molting. Molting is the shedding of skin. Now, here is the comparison of Periplanata americana and Blatta orientalis. First of all, from the size, Periplanata is larger in size and Blatta orientalis is smaller. Periplanata color is shiny brown and it is of dark brown coloration. The wings of Periplanata are well developed, whereas in Blatta orientalis, in female, the tegmina are very short and hind wings are absent. In Periplanata americana, pronotum is narrower, whereas in Blatta orientalis, these are broader. In Periplanata americana, saliva is without invertase, whereas in Blatta, these are with invertase. Invertase is a enzyme. Now, genetically, the chromosome number of male in Periplanata americana is 33, whereas in Blatta orientalis it is 47. In female Periplanata it is 34, and in female Blatta it is 48. So this is all about the cockroach. So I guess now you better understand the cockroach. Okay? Now, we'll